April 20th, 2016. It's 7:59 a.m. Gosh. This garden is just about killed me again. My knee hurting so bad. My other knee is hurting bad. My back at night. Anyway, it's done. It's done, done, done. I've been planting flower seeds around here in the evening a couple times. Got marigolds around here, and I got a host of others. Anyway, we planted okra in like the first one, two, you know, about 12 of them in here, okra plants. And then we planted, right now, we just got 12 sweet corn kernels planted. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. 12, 12 stalks of corn will be growing. And in about maybe the 1st of May, somewhere in that area, then we'll come over here and we'll plant another 12 ears of corn. And 2 weeks after that, we'll plant another 12 ears of corn. So that the corn will produce, you know, 2 weeks apart, should start bringing up sweet corn. We did that because now they're going to put cotton all around us, 300 acres of cotton. Monsanto cotton, of course. In the past, it's been Monsanto corn, and that cross-pollinates, and Monsanto's had problems with other people with their crops. So everything else is done okay. The battery on this thing's already flashing. And, you know, garlic here. We got garlic growing. Wow, it's coming up pretty good. There should have been about four more cloves of garlic coming up, but they may have gotten knocked over with the rain we've had out here a couple times. It should have been 6 and 6. Instead, we got 4 and 3. So anyway, we got beans that are coming up in the back there. I'm not going to be able to make it with this battery getting ready to shut off the camera. I'm going to go back this way and see what I can do here. None of these beans are up yet. I just planted them, though. Although that looks like maybe right there. I can't really tell that one. I don't think it is. This is one right here. One right there. Over here is the watermelon and the cantaloupe. I believe that, but I don't know if that's what that is or if that's a weed. This is in the area where I would have planted them. I would have planted them on each corners outside from each other. Here and over there. But, that's the plant. That was from last year. We don't know what that is for sure. I believe it was a zucchini. We won't know yet, though, until another 2 to 3 weeks, roughly. But we got the fencing set up here for the beans to crawl on. I got 5 or 6 stakes here for this bean. And I might make the fence go all the way back to those. Back too, those are real thick ones. Those are the ones that are metal too, the green plastic and metal. It's a plastic coated metal tomato steaks. Okay, so battery's still flashing, so I'm getting as much as I can while I can. I'm looking here if I see anything else. Thought there'd be another one coming up, maybe. Not yet, huh? These were just most recently planted, so up to this here. This is the black eyed pea, I think, or purple hull pea. Two there, one there, and then that one there, that one, and one in the back, like in threes I planted them. This one was a flora bean. There's two beans down there. Back there's the purple hull peas right there by that cinder block. There's two there, and two in the back. So, nothing. Those were just planted a few days ago, so. Right now, that's it. Nothing else is coming up just yet. But, you know, it's understandable. Wait 2 more weeks. Wait till about the 1st of May. I'll come out here and see. We should start having a little bit of everything coming up. 2 more weeks at least. Once it gets outside, the dynamic changes. We might have the tomato plants. It's supposed to rain tonight or tomorrow and tomorrow. So getting the tomatoes out is going to be a little difficult. But I want to get them out here as soon as we can before the weekend is here. I'd like to do it on Friday. That would be CJ's 10th birthday if she had not contracted cancer after we moved here, surrounded by Monsanto, infamous with their glyphosate. Look at that, 300 acres of glyphosate. Think about that. And then dogs out here and all. Anyway, CJ would have been 10 years old on Friday. So, a little angel lights up every night for her, watching over her. see what comes up next week.